Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Good morning, students. I hope all are safe and healthy. Let's move to the next part of the video on the lesson, Why Do We Fall Ill? In today's part, it's the part 6 video where we are going to discuss about the NCERT solutions of this lesson. Come on, children, let's continue. So we look on to the questions in page number 178 first. So you can see the some of the blue questions seen at the end of the topic, and that's what we are going to discuss today. Question number 1. State any two conditions essential for good health. So the answer: health is a state of well-being enough to function well physically, mentally, and socially. So all these three factors are important for a proper health. Therefore, for good health, so these two conditions are very, very essential. What are they? Proper nutrition and a balanced diet, social harmony with mental health. So other factors are also there, but here any two conditions is enough. Question number 2. State any two conditions essential for being free of disease. As we already studied, children, we know the difference between health and disease free. There's a lot of differences. So here the question is, the conditions essential for being free of disease. The answer: the two main conditions are, the person should take a proper, sufficient, balanced diet. So diet is the first important thing for the conditions to be disease-free. The next one is personal and community hygiene should be maintained so that we will not get any diseases from others. The next question comes from the page 180. The first question: list any three reasons why you would think that you are sick and ought to see a doctor if only one of these symptoms were present. Would you still go to a doctor? Why or why not? So the answer: so here a list of symptoms are given. They are headache, fever with cough, and loose motion. There are many other symptoms, but three is given here. If only one of these symptoms is present, we usually do not visit a doctor. This is because such symptoms do not have much effect on our general health and our ability to work. However, if a person is experiencing these symptoms for quite some more time, then he needs to visit a doctor for a proper treatment, because we might not know so what is the root cause and what are the next effects. Question number 2. In which of the following case do you think the long-term effects on your health are likely to be most unpleasant? If you get the jaundice, if you get lice, if you get acne, why? So I think it's very easy, but we need to know why. So getting a lice or acne is not that much unpleasant, but getting a disease like jaundice is quite to be checkable. So the answer: jaundice is a disease that can cause long-term effects on our health. It is a chronic disease that lasts for a long period of time. It does not spread rapidly, but it develops slowly over a period of time. So that's why we need to be very careful when we get a jaundice as disease. On page number 187, question number 1. Why are we normally advised to take bland and nourishing food when we are sick? The answer is, when we are sick, the normal body functions will get disturbed. In such situation, food that is easily digestible and which contains adequate nutrients required for a speedy recovery is always advisable. So only we recommend bland and nourishing food during such sickness. After sickness got recovered, we can start taking the other type of food. The next question, question number 2. What are the different means by which infectious diseases are spread? The answer, so here they asked about the different means of agents which can spread the infectious disease. So the answer, we have to talk about the different transmission of agents. First one, through air. Certain disease-causing microbes are expelled in the air by cough, sneeze, talk, etc. These microorganisms will travel through these dust particles or water droplets in the air to reach other people. So such diseases are called as airborne diseases. Such diseases are, examples are tuberculosis, pneumonia, flu. The next is through water. Sometimes disease-causing germs get mixed with drinking water and spread as waterborne diseases. So, such diseases, examples are cholera, typhoid, hepatitis. So, these diseases are caused because of the unclean water or unhygienic water. The next is through sexual contact. Sexual act with an infected person can lead to the transfer of these disease-causing microorganisms. So, this is also a one mode of spread of disease. So, example of sexually transmitted diseases are syphilis, gonorrhea, AIDS, and many. The last one is through vectors. What are vectors? They are the animals or the insects which can carry the infectious organisms, that is the disease-causing organisms. Certain diseases spread by agents like insects and animals are called vectors. So, example, mosquitoes. They can spread malaria. Malaria is caused by a microorganism called Plasmodium. This will be carried by mosquitoes, which will infect any person by that disease-causing microbe. Question number 3. What precautions can you take in your school to reduce the incidence of infectious disease? So that's a very important question during this COVID time. So let's learn about it. The precautions that one can take in a school to reduce the incidence of the infectious diseases are, first, by using appropriate handkerchiefs while coughing and sneezing. We have to use it at that time. Second one, washing hands before eating. Third one, staying at home if anyone suffers from infectious disease. That's very important so that we might not be an agent as cause of to disease spread to other. Fourth one, getting vaccinated before the infection effects. Fifth one, keep the school surroundings clean and checking for stagnant water so that the vectors which cause that diseases will be not there. Question number four, what is immunization? Immunization is defined as the protection of the body from communicable diseases by the administration of vaccines so that the body attains immunity against such disease for a longer period of time. So most commonly, this immunization is done by vaccines. Naturally, some people may get immunized. Question number five. What are the immunization programs available at the nearest health center in your locality? Which of these diseases are the major health problem in your area? So that's a question. The immunization programs will differ according to the area. So a very common programs we can see in this question. So they are the polio eradication program, the DPT, diphtheria, pertussis, and tetanus program, hepatitis B, so vaccine against hepatitis B, MMR, that is measles, mumps, rubella. So that injection is called as MMR. So these injections are commonly injected to children before age 11. So that differs according to the area or health centers. So thank you so much, students. So today we have discussed all the in-text questions. In the next video, we will learn about the book bag exercises. Thank you so much.